Churchill remains a potent figure in our national identity as the wartime Prime Minister who defended us against the Nazis. But even Churchill has a side we don't talk about. Dr. Yasmin Khan has been investigating the facts.
This is an extract from Leo Amery's diaries. Amery was the Secretary of State for India, so he's in charge of Indian policy in London. And this is the bit I really wanted to show you. He writes in his diary that Churchill has burst out with this statement. I hate Indians.
God.
They are a beastly people with a beastly religion.
I've heard it described that Churchill had these racist views against Indian people, but I wasn't expecting it to be so blunt.
He has this kind of eugenics, 19th century informed idea of how Indians are inferior to Western people.
Churchill's attitudes towards India had consequences. In 1943, failed harvests and wartime blockades led to a famine in Bengal. As it was part of the British Empire, they turned to London for help, but very little came. By the end of 1943, 3 million people were dead of starvation and disease.
The question is, could they have done something from London? Could they have thought about ways of alleviating this? Could they have planned ahead? And the interesting thing here is this is Churchill's handwriting. This is the little comment from Churchill. And it's a bit enigmatic. It says, what does this mean to you?
So he had personally seen this, which is a warning of how dire the situation in India is.
The critical thing is shipping. And what Churchill's just prioritising the whole time is the winning of the war. He's just thinking about where are ships, where can we move men who are needed on fronts. And the lives of Bengali peasants are neither here nor there to him.
When Australia and Canada offered aid, Churchill rejected it. And Yasmin thinks she knows why.
Ah, here we are. Winston, after a preliminary flourish on Indians breeding like rabbits.
God, that's really like eugenicist-type language.
It's also the fact that it's in the same breath as discussions about shipping and delivery of aid to the famine. So it's that kind of connection between his beliefs about Indians and the actual relief of the famine, and I think that's what's really pernicious.
So what does this mean for Churchill's legacy?
Most historians would tend to agree that hundreds of thousands could have been saved. The famine itself was beyond Churchill's control, but it's about how relief was managed. In Churchill's case, I think there's a punitive and slightly malicious element there, which means he turns his face away from sending aid when he could have done.
So this wasn't just wrong, it was nasty.
I think in Churchill's case, he was, yeah, nasty.